the type of defenseman Quinn Hughes is, the type of defenseman that Vancouver literally has never had.
Never had.
Sitting there, Dallas, scouts are there saying he's already the Canucks' best defenseman. Certainly he's their best skater. They've never had a guy with this kind of dynamic offensive upside, a guy who can skate like this already at 18. Yes, Dave. I want to see him. I want to see him in the lineup as soon as possible. I think the Canucks do too. Best course of action to allow that to happen, or to allow this gazelle to run across the NHL, to give this defensive mobility, to change the paradigm of the current team. Because it's pretty bleak right now, Dave.
Yeah.
Like, things are bleak. I don't know if you've heard.
Yes.
But the team that lost 146 points when the Sedins retired and Thomas Vanek left went out and got three grinders? What? How did that happen? I don't know. I have no idea what they're trying to do, but they were 26 overall in goals last year. Their three best offensive, or three of their five best offensive guys just checked out of the team, and they've got the exact same defense. So so part of this, I'm looking for something to cling on to. Part of this, I want to see Quinn Hughes. I think he's ready. And the other element to all of this is the offers weren't there. I mean, Tanev, he didn't have a great season. He wasn't great when he was in the lineup. He was hurt a lot. The big-time offer that may have been there in years past certainly was not there, has not been there. Maybe it'll be there again. Maybe the dynamic will change over the course of the season. I honestly still think that they need... like, they need way more prospects.
Yeah.
They need way more, you know, they need that army. They need a bunch of different layers to this. It can't just be Hughes, Pettersson, and Besser, and Horvat. It's got to be a lot more guys than that. Can this be revisited down the road? Of course it can. But for right now, I think Quinn Hughes' best chance to make this team, to be on this team this fall, is Chris Tanev in the lineup.
Botch, I do want to get into this meeting that's going to take place tomorrow between Jim Benning and Hughes' agent, Pat Brisson. The sense that we all get is that he will go back and play one more year in college.
That's not the sense I get at all.
I'm saying this because of what...
The Canucks are super eager to sign him because there's one great advantage to this prospect. Like, how many times have we bemoaned the CHL-NHL agreement where a guy like Virtanen comes up, not ready for the NHL, but they don't want to send him back to the CHL either, okay? Because he's done it. He scored his 45 goals, dominated the CHL. Why send him back there? How is he going to grow? The great opportunity here is that Quinn Hughes is not signed to the CHL. He's not beholden to these rules.
Yeah.
If he does not make the Vancouver Canucks, one of the top prospects in the draft, well, a lot of people think is the best, closest to NHL-ready defenseman outside of Rasmus Dahlin, can go to Utica for a month, can go to Utica for 3 months, can get ready to play. I think in the meeting, he's going to want to see a chance, right? Like right now, if you break it down, you look at the Canucks, you look at the left side, you see Edler, Delzato, Pouliot, Hutton. But there's not a big opportunity for him right now. Is Green really going to give him a chance to play over all of those guys? Anyone but Edler in training camp and give him a real shot into the preseason? I think that's the conversation. You know, is he going to have a real opportunity? I don't think he's looking for a spot, but he wants a good chance to make the NHL. And if that's not painted for him, yeah, then I think he'll go back. Like he said, it's not the worst case.
Well,
certainly not the best case, though.
Yeah.
He's saying it's not the best case. And I think Jim has said the same thing. They want him signed. I totally get it. I understand why they want him signed. They want him in the organization. They want to see if he's ready in the fall. They believe his skating is already NHL ready. They're convinced of it. A lot of people are convinced of it. They believe he has a skill set no one else on the team has. I think we all agree on that.
Yeah.
They're not a mobile defense. You know, if you could slot him in a sheltered role in a third pairing, give him big-time power. Who else? Like, anyone? Like, he's already for sure the best power play guy they have. Who else would you look at? Like, there's not even another power play guy on that defense. So give him every opportunity. If he doesn't make it, send him to Utica. I don't get what the problem is.
Well, the issue
you gotta
is...
You got to move one of the defensemen. That's the thing. You can't... I don't think he's going to come if all those four guys are sitting there on the left side.
Okay. There's the combination of that and the fact that you're going to go and burn off, you know, one of his years in a season that is not going to produce anything. That season is going to be a lot more valuable to them on the other side. There's that argument to it all. But having said that, all right, I agree with you in terms of his skating ability. They have never had a defenseman like this in terms of his puck-moving ability, and you have to have that kind of player if you're going to win in today's NHL. We agree on all of that. What we're dealing with is a 5-foot defenseman who's 160 pounds. Okay, you're going to throw him into the greatest league in the world at light speed and hope that he doesn't get hurt. I wouldn't mind, okay? I would not mind him taking one more year. It would not bother me all that much because I'm with you, like everyone else. When you've seen what you have seen, this guy is going to be everything as advertised. But is it in the best interest of the Vancouver Canucks in the bigger picture to waste this year on a season that is not going to deliver them anything? Awesome. Have we lost Botch, or did he just say, to hell with it, I'm hanging up. I'm going back to bed. He could have done that. He'll do that. As Quinn Hughes said, and I want to get into this a little bit, is that, look, playing in college again would not be the worst thing. It's not a life or death kind of situation. And yes, they've got to make some decisions in terms of where this organization is going, in terms of not only, you know, their forwards, but certainly on their blue line, which is where they have most of their depth. There are so many things that have to happen within this organization. There are some good reasons and some good arguments to go and buy another year on the back end of this contract. So I understand we've got Botch back onto it. Do you not look at the bigger picture and say, okay, where are we going to be down the road? What do we need to burn this season off now?
Well, I don't understand how developing him in the pros is burning a season. Like, that's like he's going to have hurdles to climb, obstacles to overcome when it comes to the NHL, right? Like, why not develop him now so that when the team's decent, he's ready?
He's 18 years old.
Opportunity. He just dominated college. Why do you want to send him back? I'm shocked. I'm honestly floored that this is your position.
No, what I'm saying to you is that I'm not as absolutely committed to it all. He's got to play now. He's an 18-year-old defenseman going into the single greatest hockey league in the world. Okay. And I have no doubt in terms of his confidence level.
Put him in the minor leagues. What's the damage? Sure. I don't... What?
What I'm talking to you about in the bigger picture is that you're going to burn off one of his NHL seasons, and you're going to do that.
He's developing. He's getting ready. He's like, okay, there is a transition that happens, and it doesn't matter if you spend 8 years in college, 15 years in the CHL. When you come to the NHL, you got to figure out the NHL. Like, it's an entirely different league against entirely different players, and why not have him go through those growing pains now? And get him in a position where he can be the best Quinn Hughes he can be in 3 years. When we hope, like, good Lord, the team better be good. Like, it's bleak right now, right? Like, when people are looking on the lineup and Brandon Sutter is your second line center, like, these are tough times, like, that we're in right now.
Oh, there's
so
no doubt.
In 3 years, this better be a good team. It has to be. And I would love in 3 years if this is a good team and Quinn Hughes is becoming a great player and has already gone through the growing pains in the NHL. Yeah. That's what I would hope for. I don't think it's a waste. I don't think it's burning a year off. I think it's a guy learning how to play in the pros. No.
And
figuring out what he's got to do.
And Botch, I want to make sure that we're really clear on this. I'm not fanatically committed to either side of this argument. What I'm saying to you is that they have options in front of them, okay? And that's what I'm throwing you, is the other option that's out there. Is that, look, because you're going to be able to take that year and tack it on the back end, you know, of his contract and burn it there as opposed to burn it now. That's all I'm saying. Okay. There are other options.
Can I just bring up Michael DiPietro, who is like...
Okay, do you want to get into this? Okay.
Yeah, I do, because I heard Kurt slandering this young guy. And
like, I love this
guy. He's got all the potential in the world. When the Canucks were a great team, guess what? They had two fantastic goalies, both on the same team.
Yes.
Corey Schneider and Roberto Luongo. Those are the great times. Remember those times? Does anyone remember?
Yeah.
Because they were the good times.
Yeah, the best 1-2 punch ever.
And it was a lot of fun, Dave. It was a lot of fun. And I see Kurt dismissing.
Yes.
The World Juniors. What goalie has won gold? Carey Price, Kurt. Won gold at the World Juniors.
I know, that was 13 years ago in 2005.
John Gibson won gold at the World Juniors. Jacob Markstrom, in fact, won gold. You're just dismissing.
We're talking about Canadian goalies.
This guy can be a starting goalie for Team Canada at the World Juniors at home here in Vancouver.
Yes.
Poor guy's probably, he's here in Van at development camp, probably listening to you.
He's probably not.
You know, wanting to tune in and saying, you know, what are these guys saying about the prospects? And you're saying, like, this guy's nothing. Demko's going to be the starter for 35 years. DiPietro will never play. That was tough to hear, man.
That's not what I was saying,
and this is a note to anyone that's close to DiPietro. Do not play him any recordings of Kurt Appleby today. Poor guy.
I'm just saying that in the last 10 years, Canada hasn't had anything in net. And I'm just thinking it's probably going to continue.
Steve Mason won one goal like that.
No.
Price and Mason went back to back.
And how's his NHL career turned out?
He was great.
Steve Mason.
He had a good career.
He had a great rookie year. He won Calder. But wait, how many teams has he bounced around after that?
I can't believe
we're having this conversation. Look, I want to make sure we're clear about one thing. My position from the start of the show has been this, that our Subway poll question, which is, which Canuck prospect gives you the most hope? And here's the what we rattled out.
Quinn Hughes,
you know, Patterson.
Right now.
And a 2019 first-round draft pick we threw in there as well. And then DiPietro. And DiPietro's got 1% of the
vote. Great poll question.
And I'm going...
Unbelievable.
And I'm going...
It's shocking.
How is DiPietro not getting more love? And then Kurt's throwing him under the bus. And I'm going, guys.
Because you're allowing Kurt on the air.
No, exactly.
Like he's influencing the vote. This kid wins
a Memorial Cup championship at 17. Right. He's going to be your starting goaltender at the World Juniors here in Vancouver. I mean, how can you not be excited about this guy?
NHL goalies never get invited to the World Championship. It's a men's tournament. It's, you can draw from anywhere. He got taken as the third goalie. I saw Kurt completely dismiss that. Maybe there's some nice practice video of him. Like, that was a fantastic growing experience for the guy. They gave him a great opportunity. I think he was unfairly cut from last year's Team Canada World Junior team. That was a bitter pill for him to swallow. He got a huge boost of confidence by being part of that World Championship, an invite that came out of nowhere, and was a testament to the second half that he had when he turned it on. Here's a guy set up, you know, super hungry to be the starting goalie in Vancouver to win gold, desperately wants to win gold for our country, and Kurt's just slamming the
guy.
Like, I don't know what kind of new system you have, but man, that's a lot of airtime for Kurt to be slandering young goalies across.
We're going to have a meeting about it. Thanks, Botch. We appreciate this.
Gotta go.
Going back to bed now. Jason Botchford is always brought to you.